Joe, I want to circle back real quick before we get on to your trucks. You know, we are no stranger to having vehicles with personality on this show. We've had the Michimobile for I Love Micheladas. We've had Sunny for Farm Cup Coffee. And with you, you have Charlie and Frankie.
Correct.
And so it's impressive that you were able to source one Mr. Softy truck, but two. I mean, I don't even know how many are in existence in America today, but it just seems so incredible that you were able to find two of them. Like, what was that search like for you, and how difficult and how long it was?
The first one took years. I knew exactly what I wanted. I wanted a vintage Mr. Softy truck, and to find it was just like, I was on Craigslist for every city. It was like, maybe there is now, but at the time there wasn't a Craigslist database for every city. So I would click on Texas, then Austin, San Antonio. I go to California, San Francisco, and I just searched like crazy, and it finally popped up. And I bought it sight unseen off the internet. It was a stupid move. That's literally a whole separate podcast. But so I bought the truck, had it restored, and then I was working the streets. And every time I got a private event, we had to cancel. And all of my regulars were like, what the hell? When do I get, how do we get your stuff? I was like, clearly there's a demand for the product. We need a second truck. So we started searching again on Craigslist. And no joke, it was like out of a movie, barn doors open, and this guy had four of them. So I said, I'll buy them all. And he's like, what? What do you want to do with four? I'm like, I'll buy all of them. They don't run. I'm like, it's fine. I'll take them. So now I've stockpiled them because I was telling Diego, I would love to have a standalone truck that doesn't move, just like a permanently parked truck, kind of like what's going on with Farm Cup Coffee with Sunny.
Wow. But
yeah. It was
just
wild. Sheer luck to find the other. They're basically shells.
Did you find them in LA or did you have to ship them over?
No, upstate New York was the second. Okay. Yep, so they're up there, except for one of them we shipped out, and that's Frankie. And I literally shipped the box out. I was just obsessed with that aesthetic. I wanted that classic look, but everything had to be gutted mechanically. Everything had to be redone.
I can imagine after who knows how long they hadn't been in operation. And, you know, vehicles that are made from that day aren't exactly in the best shape nowadays, even if they were running. So I can imagine like that was a hefty task for that restoration.
Yeah. And especially with the first one, I hadn't sold a single ice cream cone in LA. First of all, also there was no soft serve. So I'm going to dice on, I'm going to spend all this money on this cool looking truck and then bring this product that doesn't exist here because I think it's good. Looking back now, it's nuts.
Absolutely. You were probably the coolest dad though. Like cool dad points for sure. Right? At a minimum, you're rich in cool dad points, I would imagine.
I explain that to my kids. I say, you guys, you know, this isn't like normal. Like, we have ice cream trucks. Like, we went today to go. He's like, yeah, we go to the truck. I'm like, sure. I'm like, this is not a normal thing. Like, your friends. Yeah. So they're
awesome.
Aware that that's a treat.
When you retrofitted the truck, I know Farm Cup had this issue where basically like these cars are somewhat super unique. And so there's a limited number of mechanics, one. And then two, at least in Farm Cup's case, when they retrofitted it, the weight was just too much. And so they had this issue of constant breakdowns and then going to this mechanic who there is only one of in LA. And so what is that? I mean, obviously with a coffee, I would imagine with that vehicle, maybe it's a little different than your vehicle. Your vehicle looks a little bit bulky, but what have been the challenges on that side of it?
Oh, so I guess for Farm Cup, that's a French truck that they have. So that's a really hard thing to find. Mine are Ford engines in them. So anyone that works on classic cars can work on them. That's not the issue. But the weight of them alone, they're solid steel from the 60s. They're not fiberglass. They're heavy 10,000 pound trucks. They're slow going. Some of the limitations to the business, we don't go on the freeways. They max out about 40 miles an hour. So if I'm in the Valley and I'm doing a catering for a TV show in Santa Monica, I'm taking the Sepulveda Pass over. It takes us a while to get around, but it's worth it. I just didn't want a modern truck because I think it would just look like everyone else's and didn't really have that eye-catching appeal.
Did you have to make any odd like modifications to the truck? Because I know like we had to, or at least with Farm Cup, as we're retrofitting it, everything is, at least the health department is big on making sure there's plexiglass everywhere. And like the ADA now has a microphone. And I think the microphone, or at least the speaking thing is a newer thing that I'm even seeing just some takeout businesses do. So basically they're not yelling like they're not like, Joe, your order's ready. Instead of yelling it, they just have the little microphone thing, which is a new thing. It's brand new. It's kind of odd, but.
Yeah. The plexi thing was weird to me. You have a very small window, especially with pass through for dairy for whatever reason. It's really, I'm like, what this? It's nuts. I have four sinks on my truck. I do no prep whatsoever. We literally are pouring ice cream mix into a soft serve machine. But I had to have four sinks. We had to knock out the back wall. It was just a total, it was crazy. It took almost 2 years to get the health department to approve everything. And then the second truck was like nothing because we already had the plans. But yeah, it's just, there's a lot of red tape. And when I first went to the health department with the truck, they're like, well, why don't you just get a new truck? Like, this is crazy. Like, this thing has to be redone.
That stands to reason. The people who would work for the health department are the same people with the lack of vision to see why you would want a truck from the 1960s.
Dear health department, we love you, health department. You're our best friends. We can't do anything without you. I just want to make sure the health department understands how much we care.
We covered our bases.
We do.